For everybody in Comaria, Puerto Rico, there is a before and an after. That's because ever since Hurricane Maria came, everything is different.
After Hurricane Maria, Comaria does not look the same. No power, no water, so they had to close down businesses and not be able to reopen again.
If you were a kid in Comaria, no electricity meant no school. Not just for days or weeks, but months. That's right. For a long time after the hurricane, Inez Mendoza Elementary School was empty, except for Jorge Santiago. He came here every morning to set up the electricity for his free community laundry.
For us to start the washing machine at 7 in the morning, I had to bring generators out. And the idea with the generator was to power the washing machine only.
Jorge's generators were pretty much the only source of electricity in the whole neighborhood. Every morning, he would roll them across the empty schoolyard. Until one day, when God told him the schoolyard didn't have to be empty.
My wife and I started thinking, hey, we can also help the school. Why not? They here. You know, we had the gasoline, we had the generator, we had the tension cord. Why not?
When Jorge offered to share his electricity, the school reopened. In a town where nothing seemed to be normal anymore, this, and this, and this were unexpected and very welcome sights.
I am a teacher here, and I love my children. After the electricity came back, everything was so much easier. This whole thing has taught me that Jesus is real and that he hears my prayers.
Jorge had shown lots of people in Comaria that Jesus is real. And now, God told him it was time to take the next step and start a church.
We got to operate the school on regular schedule, and that wasn't even the idea. But God started putting that heavy weight in my heart. It was like, I need to preach the gospel. I have to.